أو تراصوا واعتدلوا ستين لاين الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين منفكين حتى تأتيهم البينة رسول من الله يتلو صحفا مطهرة فيها كتب قيمة وما تفرق الذين أوتوا الكتاب إلا من بعد ما جاءتهم البينة وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء ويقيموا الصلاة ويقيموا الصلاة ويؤتوا الزكاة وذلك دين القيمة إن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين في نار جهنم خالدين فيها أولئك هم شر البرية إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أولئك هم خير البرية جزاؤهم عند ربهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه ذلك لمن خشي ربه الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين والعاديات ضبحا فالموريات قدحا فالمغيرات صبحا فأثرن به نقعا فوسطن به جمعا إن الإنسان لربه لكنود وإنه على ذلك لشهيد وإنه لحب الخير لشديد أفلا يعلم إذا بعثر ما في القبور وحصل ما في الصدور إن ربهم بهم يومئذ لخبير الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله الحمد لله الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد وأسك الله سبحانه وتعالى to accept from us our fasting and our ibadah and our qiyam and our siyam and our dua. أسك الله عز وجل to give us life and ability and iman to finish this month of Ramadan on taqwa and iman and to make us achieve his pleasure subhanahu wa ta'ala and attain his reward subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya and akhirah. Allahumma ameen. We continue with the beautiful lessons of the beautiful surah of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, al-Kareem, ibn al-Kareem, ibn al-Kareem, ibn al-Kareem. Yusuf ibn Ya'qub ibn Ishaq ibn Ibrahim alayhim salam. And this never happened to anyone, four generation prophets, except Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. So this is Allah Azza Jal blessed him to be prophet, son of a prophet, son of a prophet, son of a prophet. And not any prophet, Ibrahim alayhi salam himself. And he went through trial after trial after trial. But then the reward comes from Allah Azza Jal at the end. And this is the model for all of us. إنما المنح في المحن إنما المنحة في المحنة. See, the word is very close. We're just shuffling the letters. منحة means gift or a reward. منحة ميم نون حا منحة. And then but you put the ha before the noon, it becomes hardship. محنة. So a person has محنة always, inshallah, there is a minha coming in it. If you don't see it, it is there. It is always there. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لَمِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّ الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Means those who go through hardship and face it with sabr, Allah Azza wa Jal guarantees there is a minha. There is always a minha in it. The minha in itself, that you go back to your iman, practice sabr, and they become attached to Allah. Actually, if this is what it is, that's enough. That's enough. If the hardship makes you a person who's closer to Allah, that's the biggest minha in the world. Don't you agree? Biggest minha in the world. That's why, subhanAllah, when a person is tired or sick or something, they're closer to Allah. They find Allah Azza wa Jal easily, subhanAllah. 2 days ago, I was listening to a YouTube video of one of the actors in Egypt who repented to Allah Azza wa Jal and left all of that. Actually, I met him in the Hajj one time, and we had a very nice chat. Yeah. So one of the things that he mentioned, he said, in one stage of my life, I was trying this atheism. He said, yeah, when in the 60s, early 70s, he was trying al-ilhad, yeah, and I refused everything. He said it was the fashion. He said, I'm telling you, it was the fashion at that time. So I was not doing it because I'm convinced or anything, but it's a fashion to doubt everything, not to accept anything, and people are going right, you gotta go left to be somebody. Yes? And so when we see what is happening around us in society, subhanAllah, it is not strange. This is the way it goes for thousands of years. Right? So he said, it's just like that. But then he said, I was reading all these books of no God and all of this, but he said, at the time when there are exams, I go pray. Sahih. It's from his mouth. يعني. He said, at the time when there is exam, or I get sick or something like that, nobody can see me, but I know myself. I will just go hide and pray. I said, Ya Rab. But then when I'm out in front of everybody, when I'm good, then he said, oh, doubt, God, what is God? Like this kind of thing. SubhanAllah, Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam was emphasizing on that. Tawheed. And never forget it, even if you are in the worst of times. Never forget. See, that's the gift I'm talking about. The gift is that you stand firm, even if everything trying to grab you away from your deen, from being a Muslim. No, stand your ground in this one. That is your actually last ground. If that one is shaky, lost. So that's why he is in jail after this temptation we talked about yesterday. He is thrown in jail out of transgression. He is very innocent. He knows he is very, he's innocent. They know he is innocent. Yet they put him in jail. You see how much is like this frustration and disappointment, like when you know that people say, we know you are innocent, but you're still going to be in jail. It's very hard on you when it is like that. At least the solace when the people transgress you, you know you are innocent, but they don't know, so you kind of, there is a battle or defense or something like that to prove it. So there is some kind of motion here. But when they know that you are innocent, but they're still in jail, then who else except Allah Azza wa Jalla go to? So when he entered the jail, there were two. The king, there was an attempt of assassinating him, poisoning him. Yeah. The king of Egypt at that time, there was an attempt to poison him. So he does not know either the man who gives him the drink, the wine, or the man who bakes his bread. The kitchen, يعني the, so it's coming from food or it's coming from drink. So he got the leaders of both and he threw them in jail until the investigation going on. But he put both of them in jail. So when he entered, دخل معه, it was at the same time. Yeah. They all three entered. فتيان, and they were young, and he's young. You have to draw those analogies, right? So he's young and they are young. And now Allah is showing him, it is not only you, sometimes also other people are put in jail also, like you. There is no accusation yet, but they are put in jail until they're proven innocent. قال أحدهما, when they, of course, saw Sayyidina Yusuf, saw his, يعني the way he looks, this is not a jail material. This person here is, you know, they said, إِنَّ نَرَكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, يعني you don't fit here. Then they see dream, and dreams were something big, and it is big in that surah. The surah has the dream in the beginning, then the two companions of the jail has the dream, and then the king has the dream, which caused him to go out from jail. يعني one dream caused him to go in the well, and one dream, you know, in the jail, and one dream caused him to come out from the jail. Subhanallah. And ru'ya for prophets is haqq. يعني the ru'ya, the vision of a prophet is wahi from Allah Azza wa Jal. And it is part of prophethood. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, this is the only part remaining from him Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam from prophethood in his ummah. So a pious, righteous person sees a dream, or it is seen for him, it is true, inshallah, Rabbul Alameen. That's why whenever you see a good dream, you don't say it to everybody. You just say it to someone pious and righteous and somebody you trust. The good dream, huh? Bad dream, you don't say it to anybody. You say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, like this, three times on your left. And don't say it to anybody else when you wake up in the morning. But good dreams is a good thing. And the Rasul ﷺ actually used to sit in the masjid every Fajr in the morning, and he said, did any one of you saw a dream? I can interpret for him. And the Rasul ﷺ, and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, sometimes he asked Rasulullah permission to interpret the dream for somebody. And then he said, is it right or wrong? Rasulullah ﷺ said, right. Or he said, half right, half wrong. And then he corrects. That was a tradition, a sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ. So this dream world is a way of Allah Azza wa Jal to give you some hints that you don't get in this material world. And it has some different types. We can talk about it later, inshallah. But there are true dreams. So they saw this dream. And when they told him, إِنَّ نَرَكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, you look like somebody who can interpret this. So why don't interpret it for us? So he said, I know the interpretation. But then he got them, right? So they need something from him, he will interpret, but he did not lose the chance to invite them to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Ah, so he said, you know, I can interpret this dream. I am from a pious, righteous family, but my people this, but kufr, iman, you know, who are those you are associating with Allah? أَرْبَابٌ مُتَفَرِّقُونَ أَمِ اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَارُ. You don't worship anybody but Allah. Allah is the one who have the hukm. Allah is the one who have the amr. My parents, Yaqub, Ishaq, Ibrahim. You know, he's inviting them to the deen of Allah. And that shows us the da'wah. Etiquettes of da'wah, right? Etiquettes of da'wah, you have to see what the community need. Someone wants you to listen, listen and then invite. Someone have a problem, through that problem, bring them in. So it is all the etiquettes of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's all the etiquettes of da'wah. Now they are all attentive. So they give them their ears. So he is giving them one step at a time. He's telling them, I can do it because I am such and such. My parents are such and such. And I'm believing in Allah. What you think about Allah, this and that. Now they are attentive. Now they listen to him. They said, now let me tell you what is your ru'yah. أما أحدكما فيسقي ربه خمرا. You used to do the wine for your king, and you are going to go innocent, and you are going to become the chief, and you are going to become the closest to him. You are going to be the one who is giving him the wine. طبعا وين حلال at that time, right? So don't, so this, then. يسقي ربه خمرة, he will give him. وأما الآخر, you, فيصلب. You're the one who wanted to poison. Right? So you would be crucified. To the point that the birds will eat from your head. يعني this is how your much your corpse will be there until the birds eat your head. قضي الأمر الذي فيه تستفتيان. خلاص. هوجي. Finish. يلا روح. Right? So then سيدنا يوسف عليه السلام tell the one whom he now believed that he will be innocent. Right? And actually he was released later. Not too much يعني. Not too long. So he told him اذكرني عند ربك. Don't forget to talk to the king. When you get closer to him, tell him there is someone, Yusuf, and that's his story with the wife of Al-Aziz and all of that. So just give some good words so I can get released from here. Right? So Allah teach him a lesson. Allah teach Sayyidina Yusuf a lesson. The man forgot. He went out, خلاص, he forgot. Forget completely. طبعاً, he's out, he's the king's chief person and all of that. Forget. فأنساه الشيطان ذكر ربه, يعني he forgot. This one forgot to, and Yusuf alayhi salam forgot to say to Allah, I know he's telling to somebody else. فلبث في السجن بضع سنين, يعني years, from 3 to 9. So علماء said 5, 7 years old, 7 years in jail after that one. When they entered, they saw the dream, he told them, then he got released right away. Then Yusuf alayhi salam stuck in the jail years until the king sees the dream. Which we will say tomorrow, inshallah. So, I got you now, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. So, you are going to go, inshallah, and study Surah Yusuf, tonight, inshallah, and read in the tafsir, and tomorrow, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, we will see the beautiful dream that caused Sayyidina Yusuf to come out, and what is the hikmah of it, wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alayhi wa sallam.